context. Okay. So I just thought about some landscapes that kind of are exist in urban diocese, school, factory, supermarket. And this one, again, is one sort of not really like an obvious one, but one that kind of added in as part of the game structure, which is a writing room, almost like a media office or like a journalism office.
So the blueprints that you created was one of these loops of image and sound recorded in the projector. And context can change, but it's kind of a matrix of recording and projecting.
Because you're going to have, at the same time, different projections and voice recording and sound.
So it became an idea, and then the other idea for the other show is
Can we express it? Can we express it in terms of the, so that I can see how you processed it?
Yeah.
So the first part is determining the architectural shape or the blueprint of your original project.
Yeah. So I, and this has got nothing to do with anything I've thought of. This is nothing that I've thought of before, so it's all very, but I thought, because two kind of central things are control and prediction of human emotion or what human can do. So those are kind of, and so I thought it'd be interesting if we would have, so the blueprint would be, so say that you would have audience from the start before they come in, maybe it would be like, I don't know how you would do it technically, but somehow say that when you go in, you don't only get your ticket, you log into a computer and you allow them to use, or like you go in and you use Facebook, you use a few sites that you've been told to use, and you do that by yourself.
Or distracted.
It's just for technologists to make sure that they know they have as much right as anyone else to do their presentation in whatever form that they want to. And that's bouncing off of last week, okay? So that's totally cool. And also theatre makers can be as theatre as they want.
Third person of the triangle, please. What do you want to add?
In your piece made me think of a piece I saw at Avignon Festival by Ravi Maru a few years ago. She's an amazing Lebanese artist. Basically, he created Rabbi's R-A-B-I-H.
We collaborate together. And last week we decided to see different people. And that was good because we actually saw the same person, but it's fine. That was good for that moment and to learn how the strip works. But now I feel like I want to jump in and
A one-to-one experience, where I need at least one person from the audience to do that kind of
thing. It's always like a showcase with that, this is actually what it can do. It's not great, but it's a showcase.
Do you want to work with me next time?